Hey, what's up, guys? This is Anthony from Anthony's Customs, and for this video, we are taking a look at the Marvel Legends Spider-Man, not really officially, but basically animated series, Smythe versus Peter Parker. I guess it is officially, like, that's the logo from the cartoon. Did they actually say these are from the cartoon? I don't know. Because they didn't do that for X-Men, I don't think. Maybe they did. I could be losing my mind. Either way, this is probably the first two-pack in this whole style of things where I think people wanted both figures. Mostly. We'll get into the details in a minute, but I think this is a good assortment of figures for a two-pack as far as not getting something you don't want in order to get something you do. So that's a good thing, and there are actually quite a few good things in this two-pack. There's a lot to talk about that's good this time, which is a really nice thing to be able to say. Unfortunately, there's also some things that are really terrible and kind of comical. No pun intended. So let's go ahead and get these guys off the stand and take a closer look. Alright, before we get into the figures, let's go ahead and take a look at my package. On the front, I do like the artwork. I think that's pretty good. It's mostly cartoon style. It's not exactly from the cartoon, but it's pretty close. This guy, very tan. Normally, when he's in this form, it seems to me that he should have the grayer skin like the figure has. This is more of a normal human color skin, so it's a little bit strange, but still nice artwork. It's appealing for not having a window. You get the VHS looking sides. That's okay. On the back, some very bland product imagery, nothing good there. And on the side, other side, some other stuff. Nothing crazy here, just a windowless package. So that's what it is. All right, let's take a look here. We're gonna do both in one video. Of course, I'm gonna just bounce back and forth and hopefully I don't forget to say anything. So Peter stands roughly, and we'll call it 16.25 centimeters. That's gonna make him roughly 6 3/8. Here he is up against Darwin. I guess that's probably okay. That's them standing on the table. Just about the same pose. Darwin's got a little bend to him, but scaling seems okay. Peter, we'll get into his aesthetic in a second. I want to get the measurements done so I don't forget. Smythe here stands, including the hair, about the same height as Peter, about 6 3/8. And that's going to be roughly 16.5 centimeters. They're pretty much the same height. They're pretty darn close. They both have a little bit of hair floof, and otherwise they're about the same. Peter looks exceptionally pink. Maybe that's just because he's exceptionally gray, but also I think Peter looks exceptionally pink. He's pretty darn pink. I think Darwin has a pretty good skin tone, and Peter's very warm colored, but it's not a big deal. Okay, so let's do a quick question of the day. As far as this two-pack goes, did you want both figures? Are you okay with this two-pack? Like, most times people say, well, I only wanted one, and I'm not buying a two-pack to just get one of them. Is that this, or are you good with this? Because to me, this is a pretty good two-pack. It's not, like, I don't really need a non-suited Peter, but I know a lot of people do, so I think that's reasonable enough. Okay, let's get into the aesthetics. This Peter Parker figure is by far the weak point of the set. The thing that stands out to me the most, well, it's not the shirt that people wanted. It's not the polo. I think most people would have wanted the white and, was it purple and teal? Something like that. My memory is not as good as it once was, but I think that's what it was. And I think most people wanted that. I don't mind personally. I do prefer that, but I think this is okay because he did wear this. So that's not a big deal to me. What is a big deal to me is this doesn't look like the cartoon. In the physique, it's certainly not accurate. He's a lot thicker than this in the cartoon. And in the face, especially. It's got this weird Ken doll, giant, goofy, doe-eye thing going on, and like an anorexic, like all the features on his face are really pronounced. It's weird, and he's got an upturned nose. Looks like he had plastic surgery. Very, very, very strange looking head, if you ask me. I do like the hair. I think that's fine. Good sculpt there. No paint on it. That's unfortunate. Paints are clean on the face, but to me, that just looks so goofy. Very, very strange. I don't know what they're doing here. This doesn't look like the cartoon, and it's kind of off-putting the way it has the big cartoony eyes with all the extra details. I don't know. There's something strange, uncanny valley, sort of something mixed in here. I don't know what's going on. Then we have other issues, like the shoulders are a really weird shape. Like the shoulder has a curvature to it, so the arm can hang flat, but it looks kind of strange. The forearms are gigantic and veiny and weird. They're bigger than the biceps. Bicep and tricep should definitely be bigger than the forearm, especially at the wrist, and he's got really big wrists, and he's fairly slender. But what is here, if you're okay with all of that stuff, it looks pretty good. It's not super glossy. That's nice. The watch has a little bit of detail on it. That's nice. It is pinless if you like that, To me, I would trade all of the problems to have pins. The pinless thing is expensive compared to pinned. So, like, it is a benefit, but it also has the downsides. Like, we'll see, but a lot of the times the joints get stuck and things like that. So, it's really a give-and-take situation. I do think the shoes look nice. However, mine's missing paint. So, you know, Hasbro gonna Hasbro. They look good enough if you're looking at the right side. So, it's just more run-of-the-mill Marvel Legends. I think there's a lot of new parts on here. I don't know for sure which ones haven't been used before. I don't buy every single Legends at this point, but mostly I do, and I think maybe all of it's new. Maybe not the jacket. I'm not positive, but it's okay. Other than the things I pointed out, it's okay. If you're already a fan of Marvel Legends, then I think you're probably going to like the way this looks. And if you're not, then you're definitely not going to like the way it looks, because there's a lot of goofiness going on here compared to the cartoon. So aesthetically speaking, I'm going to give Peter a 6 out of 10. The accuracy issues are a problem. Execution's not so bad other than the missed paint. All right, as for Smythe, the star of the show by far, and I said this on my live stream where we talked about announcements, this one was one of the ones I said is probably going to be the best Marvel Legends, at least looks-wise, in a long time. He's got such a comic or cartoon look to him. His physique is actually good. His shoulders are above his pecs. His torso looks really nice. His arms actually have some meat to them. The thighs have some sculpt and meat to them. Look at how much better it looks when the thighs have meat and then it pinches in at the knee. And then you get the calves and then it pinches in at the ankle. It looks so much better. I know his fins are throwing off the silhouette, but it's so much better. His calves also aren't ridiculously long front to back. This sculpt work is so much better. Leagues better than most Marvel Legends figures. His shoulders aren't ridiculously far forward. The only real thing I have to complain about for the sculpt on this guy is his head is too big. His head is definitely too big and it sits a little bit too high, but the rest of the figure looks really nice and it is a nice matte finish. There's texturing throughout the pants. Hopefully you can see that. They do have some paint on here on his fins, so it's better than not having it at all. Obviously we get a little bit down here on the toes and then up here on his whatever these things are. So it's okay. I still think the faces are weird. They need to really figure out what the heck they're doing with the faces, because they're not realistic enough to look realistic and certainly don't match the bodies, and they're not cartoonish or comic enough to match the cartoonish and comic bodies or the source material, so it's really strange. The paintwork is clean enough on this guy, but it does take away from his look, the way it's like semi-realistic. I don't care for that personally. I know some of you do, most of you don't, but to me, it detracts from the figures a lot. But this guy does look good. I think the only thing that really would have helped him, other than the head size, would have been a little bit of shading on the skin tones. And we do have some issues with the joints. I'll talk about that more later, even though it is mostly an aesthetic issue. Execution's not great there. But it does look good overall. I'm going to give this guy, for Marvel Legends standards, I would go 9 if he had some more paint. But since he looks like such bare plastic, even though he does have a little bit, I'm only going to go 8. But the sculpt is so much better than we're used to seeing. I really, really am happy about that. It looks so much better. Okay, as far as accessories go, Peter comes with 2 grippy hands on him in the package to hold his camera. He does get his camera, and then he gets the thwippy hands. So I guess that's okay. He does only have the one head, so his goofy face is going to be the goofy face you're looking at for a while. As for Smythe, you just get the 2 fist hands on him in the package, and then the 2 relaxed hands. Nothing special there. I'd like to see an alternate head or something. Hasbro is really skimping on accessories. I will go 5 out of 10 for accessories. All right, let's do articulation for Peter. We have the double ball peg neck, which isn't a bad example. Hasbro didn't do it totally bad this time. There's a little bit of extra play, but as you can see, there's not much room in there for that peg to move, so they could get a ton more range out of there with almost no effort. Does mean you could trim it up a little bit and get a bunch more range, but do that at your own risk. So you do get the leaning side to side. It looks up and down, just not that much. And of course you get your rotation, and you can combine those for more nuance in your posing. So that's definitely nice. Just wish they would figure out how to actually give you the range they can. All right, shoulders do raise better than horizontal. That's fine, full rotation, bicep swivel, everything's fine there. Single jointed elbow, less than 90 degrees. Can I force it? I can force it to just about 90, so I guess that's okay. Obviously, you get more rotation there if you want it. His forearms are so huge. Jeez, Peter, what have you been? Never mind. Okay, so you got the watch. That's a separate piece. The wrists underneath that get your rotation and a hinge. That's all fine. He does have an ab crunch in here. Obviously, it's a unique sculpt, so let's see how it works. Leaning back doesn't work because of his shirt. Leaning forward, he gets almost no range. So very limited posability here. Waist twist is standard. Hips, they go out a little bit better than 45. That'll probably do. Going forward, they kick almost to horizontal. They'd go back just a little bit. Thigh swivel is fine. Double jointed knee, let's see. Yeah, it's okay. It's not great. He's relatively limited in his posability. I guess they really just want you to have him standing there. He's not going to be doing any of his like crouching down poses or anything like that. But proportions are decent. Range is okay. For the ankles, you get to go all the way back, pretty much. And I'd say far enough forward. Cool thing is it is an actual ball hinge, so the ankle rocker works really well. So ankles are good. Alright, so articulation on this guy, it's fine for what it is. It's not particularly impressive. A lot of the joints have very little range when they don't need to be limited like that. And you could say that he's Peter Parker, so he shouldn't be posing too much. But he could pose a little bit better than this, so I'll give him a 7. It would be okay in your collection like this, but it would definitely be a lot more fun if you could pose him better. This guy, Smythe, let's see what they did here. Why? Why isn't the ball hit? Why is it this joint? Why isn't it the double ball peg? What is going on? So he can't look up that far, even though he has a lollipop. His hair, his mullet gets in the way, which is sculpted well enough. Can look down really far, but that's because he's got the broken neck situation that this joint creates. And then, of course, rotation is okay, but somewhat limited due to his hair bumping into whatever these things are. So his lollipop and big head definitely detract. And he doesn't have great range. For the shoulders, we get just about horizontal. You get your full rotation. Big meaty shoulders. I do like that. But then they gave us this where it's like, okay, we didn't feel like making them fit together properly. I don't know. I guess it could just be mine. But since it's like that, at least to some degree on both sides, I think they just screwed up. But you do get the bicep swivel, even though it's hardly connected. Double jointed elbows. Good muscular sculpting. Musculature sculpting. So that's nice. I like that. Good range in the elbow joint. And then the wrists have a swivel and a hinge. Nothing special there. Ab crunch on this guy. It's a good looking ab crunch when it's not posed. Let's see how it functions. He can lean all the way back, which creates a little bit of a weird situation. Okay, that's not the best looking ab crunch we've ever seen, but it does have really good range. It's not really continued up here in the sculpt, and you get these weird shelves. I think they could have finessed that a little bit more. Going forward, he does lean forward pretty far, and again, we have these weird shelves. So it's functional, but it's certainly not the best looking thing we've ever seen. Waist twist is a waist twist. It's amazing to me that Hasbro won't switch to the diaphragm joint. Well, I don't know why. Alright, hips, not the best, but certainly good enough. It's better than 45. I will take it, and they're not super gappy or anything like that. Hey, look, it can be done. They do kick forward very nicely. They don't go back all that far. Thigh swivel is gonna thigh swivel. Knees work pretty well. You can see proportioning is much better. Not perfect, but pretty darn close. That helps with the figure looking good. And for the ankles, you go all the way back and pretty darn far forward, and you get a solid ankle rocker. So his articulation, though it's not the best looking and there's some gappiness and weirdness going on, it's solid. I will give it for Marvel Legends an 8 out of 10. He should be able to pose pretty well other than his head, and be careful with these bicep swivels. All right, so as a 2-pack, it's time for the final verdict. It's not a bad 2-pack at all. I would say it's probably one of the better ones. Despite Peter being kind of a dud here, he's not terrible. And since it's only unmasked Peter, I don't think people are going to care that much about the goofiness. That's just my hunch. I personally don't care about this figure at all because of the goofiness, but that's just my personal preference. This guy makes up for it. So I'm going to say this 2-pack is probably going to get an 8 out of 10. This guy definitely makes up for this guy's problems. If you can buy them individually, this is really the only one you should be hunting. If you ask me, this one is still very much a disappointment, though much better than that really goofy other Peter Parker that we got on the retro card. So, not a perfect 2-pack by any means, but I would say far better than like the Doc Ock and Aunt May. Aunt May, I don't say aunt, I say aunt. I like this figure a whole lot more than Doc Ock, and this figure is kind of a little bit better than Aunt May, but not that much. So, there it is, guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. But that'll do it. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please do give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. And if you haven't subscribed, you might want to. I have new videos every day but Wednesday and thousands already on the channel. So make sure you come back for all of that. In the meantime, keep collecting.